We are grateful to have you with us, ma'am. She is going to impart her knowledge on butterflies and their families. Further, I would welcome our IQSC coordinator, Ms. Renita Vezirane, ma'am, who has taken an initiative to be a part of the session. And lastly, a big welcome all the attendees, our dear students and colleagues, for this enlightening session. Now, I invite our IQSC coordinator, Renita Vezirane, ma'am, kindly address the virtual gathering for the day. Madam Renita Vezirane, please over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. A very good evening to all of you, students, the Nature Club committee members, and dear Achrekar ma'am. I would love to introduce Achrekar ma'am to all our students. For all you students to know more about ma'am, Achrekar ma'am is a nature enthusiast and a nature interpreter at the Maharashtra Nature Club, Nature Park, sorry. Ma'am has done her MA in history from the SNDT Women's University. Ma'am has also worked as a staff nurse at Hinduja Hospital. And ma'am, we salute you for your commendable contribution to join Hinduja Hospital again and help in serving the patients during this COVID-19 outbreak. Hats off to you, ma'am. Now about today's topic. Butterflies are really beautiful species. They really soothe my mind when I see them flying around. And I'm sure it will be a wonderful experience listening to you, ma'am, on butterflies and its life cycle. Thank you. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your kind thoughts. I would now like to invite our resource person to take over and enlighten us with her expertise. Ma'am Sarita ji, now over to you.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, all the students. Today we are going to start our webinar on life cycle of butterflies. As we are very young, we always get fascinated by butterflies. As we remember, we go behind them and we are seeing the beautiful colors of butterfly and the shapes on the plants, and we really get amazed to see this butterfly. But since now we are seeing how the development and encroachment and plus these things, that forests are getting less and less, nearby flora fauna is getting diminished, and sometimes we really lack to see those butterflies. So at a time like this, we get to see some other time some butterfly. I don't think any person there who is not seen butterfly. So the beautiful creatures, actually, when we say the butterfly is an insect, when we say the insect word, we get some different feeling, different picture front of us. You know, since they are, when we say insects, or crawling things or something. But butterfly is one of the beautiful insects, we must say. When we talk about butterfly, we always remember sometimes how it will be, how it emerges, how they get the beautiful colors, and what they eat, what is their habitat, and all those things comes in our mind. Today we selected very light subject. We didn't go for a very deep and very heavy subject. As today we are at home and we are studying from home. So we and in this quarantine time. So we would like to have some light things, like beautiful, light-minded things. So we start talking about life cycle of butterflies. So when we see butterflies, the insects, the first thing in our mind comes, insect, that's what it means. So children, Shruti, you must know, when we say insect, that comes in a three part of body, that is the head, thorax and abdomen. Of course, they have more parts of their body like wings, they have antennae and all those things. So we'll go into a little detail of that. So first, starting of that which comes is the egg. As they are first hatched from the egg, so where they laid the egg, the butterflies always when they are mature, as they come from the pupae, they are already mature, and the mature butterfly start laying the egg. So how the egg, I don't know whether student have you seen curry patta plant or bale plant or mango plant or even a bryophyllum. Those are very commonest butterfly plants. We call them food plants. So if you observe properly those plants, sometimes go next to the plant and see there. You may get to see some different type of things on the leaves. You may think, what is this? I'm not understanding. What is this crawling? No, they are very small, tiny things, minute things. Have you seen mustard? The same mustard seed, even that is the, I can say the normal size, but there are some butterflies, they have the egg that is very, very minute, lesser than that. Khaskhas ka seed aapne suna hoga. So khaskhas or a poppy seed, utna chota wo egg hota hai. That egg is so tiny that sometimes you may neglect that. So that is the starting of butterfly egg. And those eggs are sticky. When the mother butterfly lays it on, sometimes not on, but under the leaf, okay? Leaf of the food plant of butterfly. They are sticky and that sticks to the leaf, okay? And that is always laid on the bottom of the leaf. And it takes some days to hatch. Okay, after hatching from the egg, the thing we call it larva. So we are looking here for the life cycle of butterfly. So we can say there are four stages. First is the egg, then it is a larva, or we can even you say it caterpillars. Then third stage we call it the chrysalis, or even we sometimes we call it pupa.
Sorry to interrupt here.
Yes, sir.
Presentation is going on, so you just see which slide it is. And all the students are requested to pin on IT support this thing. Nehali's login details. So everybody will be able to see the presentation.
Okay. Shall I start?
Can you see the presentation, ma'am? Can you see the presentation?
I could see. Yes, sir. I could.
Oh.
I can.
So you have to just go on saying next slide. So accordingly, IT team will help you. Don't worry.
Okay. So you will be doing so, or I am going to do it?
No. We will be doing. You have to just say next slide. You have to just say next slide. Automatically, it will happen. The next slide.
Okay, sir. So okay. Those four stages we saw: the chrysalis, egg, larva, chrysalis or pupa, or we say under the adult. So now egg we talk about, we are going for a next slide, that is a larva. Next slide, please. So larva or a caterpillar, what we say, that always, that is the first food of that larva is their own egg cell. When the egg breaks, it has, the tiny caterpillar comes out from the egg and starts eating the own around nearby egg cell. And then the larva molds or shapes its skin. Okay? And this fellow is a very, very greedy. Because later on, when they transform into a cocoon state, they don't eat anything. That we call a vegetative state. That means they are just lying down inside the cocoon. But now this is a stage larva or caterpillar is a very greedy stage. This stage, those larvas eat lots of leaves. Now, what leaves they eat? Whichever plant the eggs are laid, that plant the mother butterfly selects. Like I told you in the beginning, there are biophyllum, that panputi we call, or patthar chatta in Hindi, Marathi we call panputi. Then a mango, as you all know about mango plants. As I said, bell. So the different butterflies have their own food plant and host plant. Now, what is a host plant? Host plant means where the butterfly lays its egg. That is, that stage over, egg stage is over, then the butterfly is again on the same plant. It is the egg shell and starts hitting the leaves of the same plant. Suppose bryophyllum, for example, we are saying bryophyllum. Bryophyllum, the butterfly which gives egg on it, that is called red pheromone. But now red pheromone butterfly lays its eggs on the bryophyllum, is the leaves of bryophyllum, and it goes into stage of called chrysalis or pupa. So now we are on the third stage of the butterfly, that is larva form. So please go for it. Yeah. Okay. So larva, the chrysalis. So please go for larva is over. Now we'll go for the next slide. Sir. Okay. So now larva is over. Now we go for a chrysalis. Chrysalis is a pupa, also we call it. And it is a soft. In the first, it is a soft one. And then later on, it gets hardened. And this is a stage which stays for a 1 to 6 weeks. That is very. Yeah, it's also called as a cocoon. So that takes a 6 weeks. Range from the 1 to 6 weeks. Now, larva tissue structure breaks down and replaces with the wings of butterfly, what we see in an adult butterfly. Because most of us, we are seeing an adult butterfly always. Very rare we get to see those stages like egg, larva, and chrysalis. Very lucky if you have seen that, if you are really good observant and you are seeing the thing. Sometimes we get the flowers at home, and sometimes we see something green, crawling things on the marigold flowers and all. Then we are thinking what to do, and we are seeing on the TV sometimes some children, they are showing, they are taking that and they are putting on the plant. That is a larva. Okay, so that is takes place, that goes in a chrysalis, and this changes from the egg till the chrysalis. It is called a metamorphosis. That means one stage, what you are seeing butterfly, that you cannot see in a large, that is something different happening in there. Now, the newly emerged butterfly comes. So, next slide, please. Next slide. So, can you hear me? Yeah. Now, we come to the adult butterfly. Now, newly emerged butterfly, it needs time to get blood spread in its body. So sometimes some nature lovers or some students, they take those small pupa and they are trying to make, like want to see the butterfly, how it emerged from cocoon. So they must keep that in mind when we try to open it forcefully, the cocoon. Sometimes butterfly cannot come healthy out because that is the procedure, that is the process, very naturally. When that comes out from the cocoon, what happens is that the blood is get pumped from the abdomen, blood is get pumped towards the wing side. If it doesn't get that way, the butterfly doesn't get its blood into its wing. And that's why they may not get healthy, good butterfly to see. And this newly emerged butterfly, when it sorry, the blood flows into its ring, and then it has to get dried up its own, its natural way. That takes hours or 2 hours. Okay? So that liquid pumps into its ring from its abdomen, and most of the butterfly you will see, they emerge in the early morning. Okay? So that is a normal phenomenon what we are seeing about the butterfly. Now when we see the butterfly, we are seeing different varieties of butterfly. I think, so can you just go for the next slide? Next slide, please. Yeah. So what you are saying, this butterfly is very common. Looks a butterfly, the previous one. Okay. So tiger butterfly, what previous you saw the butterfly, that picture is a tiger butterfly. So now characters of the butterfly, the colors and the patterns, names are given accordingly. So now we are going for a body parts of butterfly. Very simple things are there, not many complex things are there. So first what we are seeing is the middle part. All of you children, when you are in the school as a kid, you must have drawn butterfly one or other day. So I remember that we are putting colors into this thing and we fold the paper and you get a butterfly. So, but you know, sometimes even now in my nature trail, I ask children, how many wings are for their butterfly? Most of the answers, two. So it's not so, butterfly has four wings. So you can see the front two, those are called four wing, F-O-R-E, not F-O-U-R, four wings, that means four, front wings. And there are two overlapping four wings, that is the hind wing. And the center part, of course, you know, the abdomen, and the little upper from the abdomen is the thorax, and where the antennas are situated, those are heads. And on the head, you could see eyes, two eyes. But our eyes, also we have a two eyes and a butterfly eye, they are a bit different. Our eyes are totally one distance. In a butterfly, they have a like a small, tiny round. Like how they see the colors, butterflies see yellow, red and green, three colors. And where, if you want to think, oh, the complex eyes, we say those are complex eyes. So what does that mean? They have eyeballs, many eyeballs together. Suppose we are taking so many straws together and bundle it in a, what do you say, in a rubber. And then you try to see from this eye, so what image you get, the similar image butterfly get, okay? And butterfly, as I told you, three, nine. How many legs butterfly has? If I ask you now, anyway, in front of you, there is a slide, so you can answer easily. That again, my always I'm asking this question to everyone, though KG to PG, everyone. So they answers many times wrong. They doesn't, when sometimes we don't get that many times to see butterfly, and even we are seeing, we are just seeing, they are flying. We never detect them and all. So this is a simple thing. They have a six legs and two eyes, as I say, complex eyes, and six legs attached to their thorax. So six legs. But when butterfly is in a caterpillar state, they have more than six legs. They have a 10 legs that time. And those are called pseudo legs. Pseudo means false, because that disappears legs. Okay? So and the butterfly, what is the food? Very simple. All of you will answer it rightly. Those are nectar. And how they drink the nectar? Their mouth part is totally different. That is called a proboscis. We are saying the huge animal, elephant, right? Elephant has a trunk, okay? When elephant eats something, they want to eat something, they extend that, okay? The proboscis is something like that, the straw-like thing. How we take some cold drink, we dip that straw into that drink, soluble thing, and we suck it. Something similar about the butterfly, they also do the same thing. They put that nectar base up from the plant flower. okay? And they test it with their feet, not with their rubber shoes. So they have this all, I told you, the four rings and two antenna. And antennas are doing the work of nose, like they are smelling. Even they get a touch with that. Next, sir. Next slide, please. This sensory, yeah. Now, antennas, there are big things, different things. Before, I must tell you that there are, when we say about butterfly, they come in a family of Lepidoptera. So, this Lepidoptera, there are some more insects are involved. Like you all, we are aware of the butterfly, but there are cousin of butterfly. You all must have spent night sometime in a village. So when we put off the light, and sometimes we see one single bulb is burning, and that time you may see there are some insects are gathering nearby that light. And those we call in Marathi patang, you know. So those we call in English moth. Moth, M-O-T-H, moth. So moth and butterflies are cousin, you can say. They are from the same family. Now, why I'm saying in between this about moths? Because the antennas are different in a butterfly and the moth. So, as the butterfly have two antennas in hand, head, I'm extremely sorry. Similar way, moths also have two antennas on there. But what is your difference between that? Butterfly antennas are a bit different than moth different. Moth antennas are bit straight and butterfly antennas are a bit club. Like you can see in this slide also. Okay, they are all knob ones. And there, male flowers, plant, and other butterflies. Now you go for eyes, as we talked before also, but I'll just tell you one by reading. Next slide, sir. Next slide. Yeah. So to compound eyes, lots of little eyeballs grouped together, as I told you beginning. Each eyeballs is little part of the butterfly I'm looking at. And to the bunch of straws, as I told you before. And now proboscis also we talk about, sir. So, sir, can you go for legs now? That also we did, but I'll just tell something more about that. Next slide, sir. Next to next, sir. Proboscis is over. Yeah, just you can have a look at that proboscis, student. Yeah, and now we are going for the legs. I told you three pairs of legs, and it takes from their feet and the plant, the nectar from the plants, and they get to. And yeah, breast-footed butterfly. What butterfly names I wrote on the slide, like morning clock, that and monarch. Not from the India actually. Painted lady, yes, we get to see in even Mumbai. And those are exceptional butterflies because you get to see them four legs in that, because their front two legs are covered with small hairs and they are very short. So it's called four leg butterfly, but they are actually in a six. Okay, now we'll go for a wing slide. So next, please. Next. Yeah. I told you this also four wings. They have two hind wings and two fore wings. And butterfly with the long, narrow wings. And how they fly? Because of their long, narrow wings. They can fly fast. But there are some butterflies, they are very slow in a flying. What is the reason? They fly slowly because their wings are larger, so they don't fly. They fly, but they are flat. This is what you say. Patterns of flying is a bit different. They do the floating, you know. There are sailor butterfly called sailor, S-A-I-L-E-R. Boat, jo naiya hoti hai, hum bolte hai boat, sailing of the boat. So who sails the boat, we call it sailor. So there are some butterfly called sailor butterfly. What they do, they don't just fly. We are seeing most of, what is our idea? Butterflies are always flying. But there are different, little bit different character. They are floating and they are a bit glide. And the wing, they glide one like that. The way of how the boat we sail, valle hote hai na, we do this side once, this side. So that way they move. So that is the difference, this thing, wing pattern. So they get a different way of, there are some butterfly, interestingly, we can say psych butterfly. So what is the psych means? Psych means mentally disturbed person. So we call them psychic. So some butterflies, the scientists have given some names like psych butterfly. So what is psych butterfly? See, the person who is not in a proper mental state, they just wander here and there. So even there are some butterflies, they doesn't know, they go once here, there. But most of the butterflies, you see, once next of finish, they go for a nest. So their names are, now tiger butterfly. Why is the tiger butterfly given name? Because wing pattern of the tiger butterfly is exactly same color of the tiger. If you are seeing butterfly, tiger butterfly, you will associate with that to the tiger. What colors tiger has? The black, orange, and white. Same colors you get to see in that butterfly. Now, there are some butterflies, like I am going to talk about camouflage. That gets too nicely camouflaged. Camouflage means they get involved, they get immersed, they get fully similar way of, what we say, they get mixed into surrounding. So that is a camouflaging. So they get, this is very useful. There are some predators. What is predators means? Who eats the butterfly? So those are not going for a tiger butterfly. Now why not going for a tiger butterfly? Their color, and there are some other butterfly, their colors are similar. That I'll go, going to tell you later on. Now sir, for the scale we are going, anyway sir has changed already. Now if you see this butterfly, you say, oh, nice pattern. But how that pattern they get? Because of their wing scale. आपने सबने मछली देखी होगी, तो इफ यू ऑब्जर्व द फिश कैरफुली, यू सी द स्केल्स ऑन इट्स बॉडी. सो सिमिलर टाइनी स्केल्स यू गेट टू सी ऑन अ बटरफ्लाई विंग, बट अनलेस यू यूज द माइक्रोस्कोप यू डोंट गेट टू सी इट. इट्स अ वेरी 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 माइनर स्ट्रक्चर इट इज, एंड दैट स्केल्स ओनली गिव्स द कलर्स एंड पैटर्न्स टू दैट बटरफ्लाई. ओके, वी गो फॉर अ नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. Next slide, sir. Next to that, okay. Now here you are saying the butterfly, tiger butterfly. Previous, sir. Previous one. Okay. So now your right side, what you are going to see is the tiger butterfly. There are many butterflies, they are mimicking those these butterfly, because this butterfly is poisonous bit. Why it is poisonous? As I told you in the beginning, their host plant decides that, because apni rui ka plant dekha hoga, aak, ya to rui or a giant milkweed call it. If you break that leaf, you get to see a white latex on that. That latex is bit poisonous. And those butterflies, they fed on this leaf. So automatically they ingest that sap, and those butterflies get them poisonous. So that happens, that helps for some butterfly to hide from their predators, from their enemy. Because there are some butterflies like tiger butterfly, they are taking advantage of this. Now the other left side butterfly, what you're seeing, that is a blue mormon, and that is our state butterfly of Maharashtra. As we have national animal, similar way we have a state animal, state bird, state butterfly, similar way. And Maharashtra is one of the first states to declare its butterfly. So what you are seeing in your left side, that is the blue mormon, yeah, black color and blue color, I think that is the state butterfly of Maharashtra. Now I would like to tell you not Maharashtra, India's butterfly, the largest butterfly is a southern bird wing that we get to see in a Kerala state, and that is India's largest butterfly. And the tiniest butterfly is called a jewel butterfly. Okay, we'll go for the next slide, sir. Next slide. Yeah, this is a caterpillar goes through metamorphosis and changes a butterfly or a moth. They both are same family, like they are cousins. So moths and butterfly big difference. Moths, as I told you, you can see them next to the light at the night. So butterfly always the day flyer and moths are night flyer, most of them. But there are some exceptions. There are some moths, they even fly at day. So next slide, please. Yeah. Now, this what you are seeing the picture. Sometimes you may see, say this is a butterfly, but this is not a butterfly. This is called a moth. M-O-T-H. Moth. Yeah, Hindi mein parwana we call it. Marathi apan manto patang. So this is a picture of that. So this is called a tusher moth, which is the largest. If you are very fond of doing trekking and jungle safaris, and you go in the villages, you are taking interest, you may see this large type of creatures. Those are moths. And sometimes it comes in a winter, month of winter, you see, sometimes it enters in a home, sometimes it makes to the light. Those are two flies next to two light. Those are moths. Okay? So next slide, please. Next slide, sir. Yeah. Now, what is the camouflage? As I told you in the beginning also, that is their defense. You know, defense means, see, everyone. Now, we have our hands. Animal has their claws. Some animals, they have a horn. So, they know how, or some snakes, they have their poison in them. Scorpion have their sting. So, similar way, everyone got their own weapon with them to defend themselves. Now, this poor creature's butterfly, they doesn't have any of this. So how they save themselves? So how they protect themselves? So they have got some or other defense mechanism. So camouflage is one of them. You see moths, if they are next to you on the tree, you may not get to see because they nicely camouflage to that tree. Sometimes on the ground, you even don't notice them because their body patterns are so much similar to that flooring or that tree bark, or even sometimes to the leaf that much there. So that word is a camouflage. We call it Marathi anukulan. That means they are anukul. Anukul means good for, or you can say, mixing to the pattern. So that is moths are more camouflage than this moth. But there is one butterfly called blue oak leaf. If you, I don't have picture right now, but I think that I'll just check, I'm not very sure. So that blue oak leaf butterfly, that is just next to you, but you cannot see sometime that, because it is so similar to the leaf of the oak tree. Even sometimes any other dry leaf you are seeing on the ground, it's just similar to that. But then why the name is the blue oak leaf? When it opens its wings, you see that is a vibrant blue color. And this the mechanism, protective mechanism, when they close their wings, they just get mixed in a surrounding. Next slide, sir. I think this is a camouflage, you can see. Next to that, sir. Next, please. Yeah. Now there is a big difference here. You are saying the butterfly antennas, you can see in a both picture, bit different. Butterfly antennas are having a knob-like thing on their end. And here you are saying the moth's antenna, they are little, you can see tiny hair-like thing. That word we call in them fringe. Okay. So that antennas are fringe. Moth antennas and butterfly antennas are different from each other. Now you go for a next slide, sir. Yeah. Now their habit, different habit. Butterfly, when you do a butterfly study, of course, you must know about moths. Because if you are doing study of butterfly, and if you are saying, because many of the moths, people think they are butterfly. They are not butterfly. So if you know the tiny difference, minute difference in them, you can easily make out either they are butterfly or they are moth. So but you see, butterflies are cool-blooded. Their blood is cold. And when you see the sun rises, butterfly, they flutter their wings and they are doing basking. Now, what is basking? Basking is a butterfly. They open their wings and they suck the sun rays for their energy. So they get ready to fly whole day. And otherwise, when they are resting, when they are not basking, they keep their wings together, like they are closing them. But when the moths are resting, they always stretch their wings on both sides. So that is one also difference. So you are seeing left hand side, those are butterfly, right hand side, that is a moth. Okay, now next, sir, please. Next slide, sir. Okay. Now, what is the use? Why they are important? That we'll talk a bit in next slide also. But here, just in a general, we'll talk about. Now, moths and butterfly, what are they doing in the nature? What is their importance in ecosystem? Of course, both of them, they are carrying the pollen from the plant, from the flowers. And this helps for a crop production. Okay, as we say, honeybees, very, very important. These scientists, very well known, are Einstein says, if there are no honeybees, there will be no human being can stay even for a 4 years. So, though butterflies are not that good pollinator, but of course they do have their role in the nature, in the ecosystem to do pollination. Of course, there are many more other uses. Next slide, sir. We'll go for a defense. As I told you in the beginning also, there are different mechanisms. Now, anyway, this what you're saying, similar to the tiger butterfly, is a monarch butterfly. Anyway, this slide just for a knowledge of you. This is not a tiger butterfly. This is called a monarch butterfly. Many children, they come, they'll learn in their book. Show me the monarch butterfly. Say, show me the cuddles butterfly. Those butterfly we don't find in India, but similar color. Now, tiger butterfly is similar to monarch. Cabbage butterfly is same to the grass yellow butterfly, so similar. So this slide, we'll go for a next now. Yeah, defense mechanism, we'll go for a next. I'll talk about defense later. Now migration. So butterflies do migration? Yes, butterflies are migratory. They can migrate. Even they can go 12 miles per day. 12 miles per day they can fly, okay? And they migrate even 400, 4,000 miles. why they migrate, what is the reason for migration, because they want to migrate from the cooler place to the warmer place. And mostly they night time they take rest, and that is on the trees most of the, and sometimes I don't know whether you know, have you heard about a plant called tag, jute plant? There is a plant called jute plant, whatever, jute bag, something, and we call it Marathi khulkhula, that children, we give them in their hand, that sound comes, no, like khulkhula, so their pods are like that sound. That plant, if you get to see sometime, you get to see, you know, after Mumbai you cross from Thane, Sanjay Gandhi National Park, or you go to Ehur, or you go ahead Panvel side, you will get lots of those plants. And you will not believe that plant, if you see in this, especially in winter. Winter is a good time to see butterflies. If you are really a butterfly lover, you can see those butterflies in winter. Also, you can see that tree, you can call it butterfly tree. That many butterfly on that set. And especially the tiger butterfly species, you will see. This is the, that's why they call it the butterfly tree. Okay? So butterfly migrate. Even height, you can say even a 13th floor of building, you can say that much height they can go. Okay, next slide, please. We talk about this, the butterfly can see the red, green and yellow colors. This is all again revision for us, four wings, antenna to see. One more thing, most of the time, female butterflies are bigger than a male butterfly, and this for nectar they fly from each plant that we talk about. Next slide, sir. Now before telling, now you always say she's talking about the butterflies, that where we get to see the butterflies. So very nearby place for you is a Maharashtra Nature Park, where I am a nature interpreter. Sadly, now it's converted in a COVID center, because next to Dharavi, all the areas, people, they have kept them a quarantine there, and even front area is also for them use. But when it get open, luckily, we'll hope for a soon, and that place, we get to see more than 80 species of butterfly. So all over India, we have 1,500 species of butterfly altogether. There is one more good place, but that is far from Mumbai, that is Amboli, one of the best place to see butterflies in Konkan, but not necessary always. You can see even a Thane, Ebur, and nearby so many, Tungareshwar, and all those areas. So that I told about SGNP, but nearby you is the Maharashtra Nature Park, and the whole Mumbai we have a 150 species of butterfly. So half, more than half, you get to see in the Maharashtra Nature Park. So when it gets open, you can see, as Sir Prashant Konkani, sir has visited, your students also come there. So you can come there. If I'm there, I'll be really with you to show them. And we'll study the whole life cycle of butterfly in actual, to see, and we'll see a different butterfly species. So can I get the next slide, please? Next slide, sir. This butterfly, we saw it. Host plants, I told you, very common plants are, as I mentioned you, the bale, kari patta and all. And lantan, one of the plants, what we say, lantana kamara. Actually, when we are talking about the plantation of trees and plants, we always give an importance to our native plant. We say not to plant exotic plant. Reason is for our biodiversity. We always like to have our own plant, native plants, because those are good for our environment, birds, flora, fauna, excuse me. But there are something very different from that. Lantana camara is one of the weed, actually tropical American weed it is. And though it is exotic, we use lots of these plants, especially to attract butterflies. Why this plant is not advisable? Because this plant extracts all the nutrients from other plant if you have a good plant nearby. But here, something different. If you want more and more butterfly, you must plant a lantana camara. So that is, so what plant you are seeing is similar lantana. This is not exactly like. Now, next slide, we are seeing a lantana's plant. So next slide, yeah. Now you are seeing the tiger butterfly, striped tiger. Why this first type? You can obviously see that there are stripes, lines on that wings. That's why it is a striped tiger. There is a similar butterfly called plain tiger, where you will not see the line. Okay. So what down it is written Danas genicia, those are the botanical name, zoological name or a scientific name we are saying. Next is a common leopard. Now, how names are given and why it's given? By seeing this picture only you can know. Leopard color, similar color of the leopard. Yeah, black dots you are seeing on a yellow pattern. And those plants you are seeing, the tiny plant with the tiny flowers, that flowers differ from the color. Sometimes pink, blue, yellow, sometimes even mixed. And this is a, well, those are plants called lantana, one of the best food plant of butterfly. Next slide, sir. Next slide. Now you are seeing your left hand side is a tail jay. That is the very fastest butterfly, you could say. And next slide is a lion swallowtail. So those are just example I'm giving. Next slide, sir. Now again, left side is a red mirror. That down is a, if it is easy for you, you can keep remember. Otherwise, just leave it. And right side is a blue tiger. Now, why tiger? Tiger, I'm saying that tiger, those plants are poisonous. I told you in the beginning, those are fed on a rui plant. Rui matlab giant milkweed. And those plants are poisonous. So, those what whichever tiger butterflies, names I read, blue tiger, plain tiger, striped tiger, those all are poisonous butterflies. Poisonous for whom? We don't eat butterfly, right? So, butterflies eaten by which creatures? Frogs, lizard, chameleon, mantis, snakes even, that is very, very exceptional. And those butterflies are avoided by those birds and all. Why? If they eat those butterflies, they feel sick, they will feel giddiness like thing, they may vomit after eating. So they try not to eat those butterflies. Now, next slide, we'll go. Yeah, sir, it's okay. Okay. This is the now you see left side blue oak leaf. Now you're seeing this half wing open. That's why it looks similar to like butterfly. But when it closes its wings, does nothing but a dry leaf. And again, your common wanderer. Now there are so many butterflies which you may get confused in the beginning. But once you start seeing a difference, very, very easy for you. It's nothing rocket science about that. Very simple. You will develop the interest. You will learn more about characters. And now you may get confused with a common wanderer and a blue tiger. Now there is a big difference. Now shaving of the common wanderer is a end. Margin is a black. But if you see blue tiger, there are dots on a black. Both colors are same, but the pattern is different. Next slide, please, sir. Yeah, now your light, right? No, I'm sorry. Left side is a southern bird wing, one of the largest butterfly of India, not a Maharashtra. Which one I told in a Maharashtra? That is a blue blue mormon. Okay, blue mormon is the Maharashtra's largest butterfly, and this is the India's largest butterfly. And now you are seeing a great egg fly on your right side. That butterfly, when it closes its wings, it looks similar to common crow. This is a butterfly name also. So they, you may get confused in the beginning for seeing butterfly. Next slide, sir. Yeah, what you are seeing is a lantana camara with a yellow flower. One of the, if you are really liking, you can plant it in your home. It's available in Maharashtra Nature Park, but not now, when it will get open. Okay, next slide. Now, in this, we do in a short, now conserving of butterflies. So, for an environment, it's a very beautiful creature. People love it. Children draw it. Scientists study it. Zoologists and all these taxonomists and everyone would like to know about. Not why they are important. So they are beautiful. They are important for ecology. Many predators are there. That is one of the food chain, most important part of food chain. Now, why they are important in an ecosystem? Next slide, sir. Moths and butterflies both are pollinators. Pollination of flowers. Now, butterflies and moths are indicator of healthy environment. Sometimes you see in some factory, nearby factory area, and this unhealthy polluted area, it's very difficult to see those butterflies. But once you are in a nature, in a fully forest-like thing, and if you have a host plant, that is an indicator of the healthy environment and healthy ecosystem. Okay, and why this is one of the invertebrates which gives the other invertebrate the food. Okay, now which butterfly area and moth areas are getting less and less. So that is our duty to plant more and more their host plants, give them good habitats, and that's what we can do. So you can go for the next slide. Next slide, sir. Yeah. Also, as I told you, there are one feature comes on other, I mean, to eat them, their predators, and they are, you know, that chain. They are in a food chain. Prey of birds, bats, other insectivorous animals. Leave this slide because this study done in Britain and all. So we are talking generally about all areas. Okay, so that is same everywhere, whichever nature, whichever area, whichever thing, you get the same duty they have there. Next, please. Next slide. Next sir. Yeah. Now what we talk about same thing. Now in a simple rewinding this analysis, the diet, meal, diet of the butterfly or caterpillar, different stages are different. Like caterpillar eats the eggshell, then the leaves, and then they need sometimes water also. One misconception which I'll get always, we think butterfly drinks only a nectar. No, there are some butterfly which they even drink the tears of animal, sometimes the poo of animal, that sweat of the human, rotten fruit. Those all are also the food consumed from the butterfly. We always talk about the nectar, but no, there are so many butterflies, like a black raja and the nawab. Those are butterflies' names. You will get wonder to see, you will get surprised to see those butterflies, even they feed on a waste or a fecal matter of birds and even animals. Yeah, so that is something interesting. Next slide. Next slide, sir. Next slide. Now their behavior about that we talked about the life cycle we talked about at to adult and undergo series of those physical transformation that we call a metamorphosis. This is revision, I could say. And this is same thing I have just kept for. If you want to read, you can just have a fast one. Defense mechanism, yes, that is sometimes they look similar. Next slide, it is there, defense mechanism. So you can go for the next slide. This is just revision purpose I kept those. So this is again defense mechanism, I told you. So there are some butterflies, they mimic this tiger butterfly and all to just get hidden from their predators. The bed is for tiger butterfly. So those butterflies also just mimic them so that they will get safe. Next slide. About threats, what are the dangers for butterflies? Because there are all the things we are seeing today is like everywhere, construction, residential, commercial, agriculture, and all those things that whole ecosystem gets disturbed. Similar way, same thing with no plants, no butterfly. Similar way, this is also applied for a butterfly. Okay, and now butterfly, if you get a chance, really try to learn butterfly's life cycle. Once you get to know their habits, your interest will develop more and more, and you can learn many more. And once you get interest, you will really be a very good butterfly observer. And there are many people comes in a Maharashtra Nature Park only and only for a butterfly study, butterfly photograph. There are good magazines over there, like a Century Asia, WWF. WWF is not a wrestling, but WWF, but World Wild Fund for a butterfly. World Wild Fund for nature. And those magazines, they are giving good importance to the butterfly photograph, butterfly study. And this is for your personal development and your personal interest. You can come to our park, you can take a photograph, and you learn and you'll really enjoy seeing those butterfly, their food plant, their host plant. Side by side, seeing a butterfly, you will develop interest in a nature. You will learn about plants and how medicinal plants are there. Even you will get interesting animals there because you see the snakes, etc. And reptiles also are there. Bulls, the birds, you can see migratory birds, etc. So, thank you, sir. I think if any question about this, as you decided, as you like, we are thankful to you, sir, and we end over here for butterfly slide.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank
it
you,
was
sir.
A really informative session. We are delighted for this. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, sir. Very, very thankful to you and students.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ma'am. Now I would request our Nature Club member, Dr. Tasker ma'am, to proceed with the question and answer session. And also I would request all the attendees to put their questions in the chat box. Now over to you, Dr. Tasker miss.
Thank you, Tasker sir. Ma'am, there is one question. Before taking the question answer session, participants, there is a feedback link in the chat box. Please fill the feedback link, feedback form. There is a question, ma'am, in the chat box. Roshni Shahu, she is asking, how long do the butterflies live? Please, can you answer, ma'am?
Yes. Butterflies are very, very short-living insects, animal, you can say. And those butterflies are having very short life, from a 15 days. Okay? The starting from a 15 days till a, the longest living butterfly can say 9 months. That is And if each morning clock, the butterfly name is a morning clock, very long living butterfly.
Okay, ma'am, one more question last. Okay,
yes, ma'am.
Butterflies are existing nowadays, we can't see butterfly. How we used to see in our childhood. What is the reason behind that? Okay, there is no butterfly in nearby area or green area.
Yeah, as I told you beginning, student, listen, as we are facing climate change, we are facing this development everywhere. You see, forests are wiped away and we are developing the monos, metros, roads, construction, factories, resorts and all those things. Slowly, slowly that vegetation goes off. Of course, without vegetation, there will be no butterfly. Butterfly, you cannot keep at home, okay? We need plants for that, of course. Without plant, there will be no butterfly. To get their life cycle continue, from egg, larva, caterpillar, chrysalis, whatever, unless plant, there are, as plants are getting lessened, we are get butterfly also get less and less. But there are some butterflies. As the CRs, ma'am, just a minute. A very simple way to get butterfly to bring front of your door, simple way, plant a curry patta plant, which is very easily available. I told you, like curry patta, mango, bryophyllum, panputi bolte hain hum log, patthar chatta, those are simple plants. 100% you will get butterfly on your door. You bring a curry patta, simple plant. Curry patta plant or a bryophyllum plant. Mango, bear, you to bade bade plant hote. You will say, I don't have a place in my door, that much big plant. So just bring on a pot. If not possible, bring a lantana kamara, simple plant. But that plant, try not to get spread everywhere because that occupy whole place. Any other question?
Ma'am, there's two more question in chat box. We will take this question. First, Shahad Khan is asking, what do butterfly taste with their feet? And second one is from TYBBI students. Can butterfly skin very sensitive? Can we touch and butterfly dies? These two questions are there. We take these two questions and then we move ahead for the vote of thanks. Ma'am, please answer this question.
What's my first question, he said?
What do butterfly taste with their feet? First question.
Yeah. Butterfly taste by their feet, that is their sensory organs, you can say. They see for a test first. Taste. How the test. Sweet. Most of the nectar is sweet. Sometimes it is little pungent, you know. So they test, that is the receptors there available in their feet. Okay, also antennas are helping for their test, for sweetness, the nectar, and always one more thing, testing, it is not a solid thing is required. They need a bit liquidy, this thing, moisture must be there, then only they can test easily. If you put something very dry, stone-like thing, they want, because they need a bit moisture or liquid thing. So that is their receptors, their antennas. That's how they get to. And next question was?
Can butterfly skin very sensitive? Can we touch and butterfly dies? This is the second question.
Yeah, good question. And yes, butterflies are very, very sensitive. Their wings are very fragile. If you know children, when they are small, they try to hold these dragonflies, they put these threads on their tail, and they try to fly. It's like a helicopter. So something similar here for the butterflies. I told you in one of the slides that some enthusiastic people, they try to bring this pupas at home, and they want to see the process, how the butterfly comes out from that pupa. So that time butterfly doesn't get survive, they die. Why? Because their body is very, very soft, and their wings are very soft. Their nerves are there, their blood vessels. Blood vessels are there, and blood vessels are very tiny. Blood vessels can get damaged with our hand, with our touch, and that's why butterfly can die with our touch. If you hold, but one more thing I would like to tell you. I do hold sometimes butterfly, but our technique.